Hi everyone, welcome back. This is the third webinar of our webinar series on WSO2 updates. I'm Vimukti Pereira, and with me I have Savindu from the installation experience team here at WSO2. So our team focuses on installing WSO2 products on various platforms such as Docker, Vagrant, AWS, Kubernetes, etc., and also developing and maintaining configuration management resources such as Puppet and Ansible. We also focuses on delivering updates to WSO2 products as well. So our topic for today is delivering continuous updates to the environments managed by Ansible. Let's move on to the discussion points. So in today's webinar, we are going to talk about why you should use Ansible. And with that, for anyone who is new to configuration management, I will give you a brief introduction to Ansible as well. Then we will talk about Ansible resources for WSO2 products and the architecture of WSO2 Ansible resources. So when it comes to continuous update delivery, we use the in-place updates tool to deliver updates to the environments managed by Ansible. The features of the in-place updates tool make it very easier. There, I will give you a summary of the features of the in-place updates tool as well. Then we can move on to the demonstration on how to use our Ansible resources in your environment and run the scripts with it to deliver updates to the in-place to the environment managed by Ansible. So let's move on to why Ansible. So as I mentioned in the discussion points, I will give you a brief introduction to Ansible first. So Ansible is an open source configuration management and a provisioning tool, which is similar to Puppet, Chef, and so on. It can be used in automation, infra service orchestration, app deployment, continuous delivery, and so on, while ensuring security and reliability. Ansible is appropriate for managing all kinds of environments. That is, from small setups with a few instances to enterprise environments with thousands of instances. Ansible is a powerful tool, and also at the same time, it is very simple and easy to use. Also, Ansible can provision from the latest cloud platforms to network devices and even to bare metal servers. Ansible has more than 1,000 modules. These modules can be executed using the playbooks to achieve the end state of a managed host by controlling the services, packages, and files in the managed host. So unlike Puppet, Ansible has a push-based architecture. That is, the Ansible server will connect to the managed nodes and push all the modules to them. As I mentioned before, these modules are written to be resource models for the desired state of the system. Ansible then executes these modules over SSH by default and removes them when finished. So let's move on to why you should use Ansible to manage your environment. As I mentioned in the Ansible introduction, Ansible is easy to use. It has a very low learning curve, and it uses human readable simple language. So to write Ansible playbooks, YAML is used. YAML is a very easy to read, very human readable language. So it is very easy to set up and use Ansible, as it has an agentless architecture. The only requirement is that the control agent should be able to, or rather should be given access to SSH into the managed nodes. So you don't need to install anything on the managed nodes. So Ansible being a declarative language means that you are writing the code and you decide what the status of your server should be. So after running the code, you can mention what there should be and what you shouldn't have. The program will decide what to do to achieve the target state of the server, and you do not have to worry about it. So when you define your system using code, it will help you minimize the risk of human errors. So with automation, you can eliminate the manual work and deploy faster. So basically, using Ansible is way more reliable than configuring your system manually. Also, Ansible helps in automating all the system administration tasks. You can define a playbook that describes the desired end state of your system and takes care of making sure the system and Ansible takes care of making sure the system meets that desired end state. So likewise, large systems can be governed using Ansible server with a well-written Ansible playbook. So to explain my last point, you can minimize the cost when expanding your business. So let me explain what that means. So you have a small business, and based on the traffic, you only need two API manager gateways. If you configure the nodes manually without using a configuration management tool like Ansible, as it is just two nodes, it won't be a big burden. So after a while, your business expands, and now you need maybe 10, maybe 100 API manager gateways. Now you have to scale your infrastructure, and also you need a better way of managing the infrastructure, as it is not easy to manage 100 nodes manually. The cost of this is pretty high, but if you have used Ansible at the initial stage of your deployment, that is when you are with just two nodes of API manager gateways, it is just a matter of adding a new managed node or several managed nodes to the deployment and changing the Ansible playbook and the inventory accordingly. Okay, let's move on to Ansible resources for WSO2 products. Our installation experience team have developed Ansible resources for all the WSO2 products, which includes the WSO2 API manager, identity server, enterprise integrator, and stream processor. So all these resources are open source and continuously updated and very easy to use. So let's look into the features of Ansible resources provided by WSO2. WSO2 Ansible modules are written in a way that it would make it easier for anyone who uses them to construct a WSO2 recommended product deployment pattern easily. So these product patterns could either be a set of profiles or runtimes of a certain product, or a combination of several product profiles or product runtimes, or combination of both. For example, you can use the Ansible playbooks for WSO2 API manager and create a recommended API manager deployment pattern, which might include two API manager gateway nodes, two traffic manager nodes, two publisher nodes, two API manager key manager nodes, one store node, two API manager analytics worker nodes. Also, you can use Ansible playbooks for identity server with the Ansible playbooks for API manager to create a solution recommended by WSO2, which may include two APM all-in-one nodes and two identity server nodes. Our Ansible resources are written in a way that it will enforce the best practices recommended by WSO2 and also by Ansible. That means our Ansible resources contain the best practices recommended by Red Hat, the recommended system configurations to run a WSO2 product, and best practices recommended by WSO2 when configuring a WSO2 product. Okay, so easy, it is very easy to use these modules as we have documented everything. Everything you need to know about extending and customizing Ansible resources. Ansible has a very good set of documentation itself, but if you face any blockers or if you have any questions on the Ansible resources provided by WSO2, we are happy to help. So you can send an email, or you can open a support ticket if you have a WSO2 subscription. Or you can contribute to our open source resources by creating an issue on GitHub. Also, you can create a free trial with WSO2, which will be valid for 15 days. Moving on to the most important feature included in our Ansible resources, which is continuous update delivery. So here, we use the in-place updates tool provided by WSO2 to enable this feature. If you attended our previous webinar on updating your WSO2 products, you know how in-place update tool works. So if you couldn't attend our previous webinars on WSO2 updates, let me give you a brief introduction to how this in-place update tool works. So in-place update tool is the latest addition to the WSO2 update story. The tool is capable of identifying your product, identifying if there are relevant updates based on the channel you have updated your product previously, or then downloading them and applying them on top of your customized product. So this tool is capable of merging updates on top of your customized text files, such as JSPs, Jaggery files, automatically. If there are any conflicts, the in-place updates tool will list out the conflicts for you to resolve manually. Please note that a conflict is a very rare case. So in case of if you come across a conflict, as I mentioned before, you need to resolve it manually and run the in-place updates tool again. To see whether you have conflicts before running it actually on your product, you can use the dry run feature of the in-place update tool as well. So this tool is also capable of reverting back to your previous state as it generates a backup before every run. You can find all the details about in-place update tool under official WSO2 documentation. And we have given the link to the documentation under resources at the end of this slide deck. Okay, back to continuously deliver updates to Ansible. So what we do there is we use the features in the in-place updates tool in our scripts to update the product before it gets shipped to the Ansible managed nodes. So Samind will show you how we do it in the demonstration. So before that, let's look at our Ansible playbook architecture. So this is our Ansible playbook architecture. So here at the bottom, you can see the sitetml, which is the Ansible playbook. There you can configure the managed nodes you need to ship your changes. So our default Ansible playbook contains all the managed nodes there, but based on your requirements, you can change this for each run. So I will explain this further in the demonstration. So on top of that, we have Ansible roles. Each role defines a product runtime or product profile. So for an example, we have APM role, which is a product profile, and we have APM analytics worker role, which is product runtime. And also we have APM gateway roles, etc. So in each role, we have a set of templates. These are the files from the product which are parameterized in order to apply values based on your environment. Also, we have the set of tasks there. So you can see tasks here. which includes everything needed to be done to achieve the required end state of the managed node. So there we have a main YAML and a custom YAML. The main YAML contains all the profile specific tasks that are needed to be done. And anything you want to add, you can add to the custom YAML. As I explained before, extending and customizing is just a matter of adding your code to the custom YAML. So there is a common role in these Ansible roles. So creating, so the common role consists of all the common tasks which are common to all product profiles and product runtimes. So what we do there is we create users and user groups, installing JDK and other common tasks for all the profiles and runtimes. So on top of Ansible roles, we have environment. So WSO2 Ansible resources only contain the dev environment. They are in the group was here. All the variables common to groups can be found. So in the host was right below it, you can find the variables specific to each host. So to give you examples, database configurations comes under group was. As they are common to all the profiles or runtimes, but a DNS name of a host comes under the host was. So Savindu will give you more information on that as well. And we have the inventory. So to manage so inventory contains the host names where this the host in the environments are mentioned in the inventory. So to manage a new environment, what you need to do is take a copy of the dev folder and then name it as staging. Then change all the parameters which should change based on the environment. Then you can run the same playbook against the staging folder to create an identical environment. So please drop a question if you have questions about the architecture. We are planning on answering questions at the end of the webinar. Okay, let's move on to delivering continuous updates. This diagram is to give you an understanding of how the updates are shipped to the environments managed by Ansible. As you can see, there are three environments here. So we have dev environment, we have staging environment, and we have production environment. So all the managed nodes here are synced with the Ansible server. So if you go through the diagram, you can see that the update level X, the Ansible server has the update level X. And this dev environment has the same update level and the staging and so on. So to update all the environments in your deployment, what you need to do is you need to run a script which is provided with the WSO2 Ansible resources. You can update your product to update level X plus 1. In this script, we use the in-place update tool, as I mentioned before. By running the script, you can update your product to update level X plus 1, and then you can ship them to your environments. You can ship them to your environments. Okay, so let's move on to the demonstration and see how easy it is to do all these things I have explained just now. So in the meantime, if you have any questions, please send us those questions. Over to you, Savi.
All right. Thank you, Vimukti. So before we begin, let me do a very quick recap of our Ansible architecture. So you can find Ansible roles for all of our products on GitHub. So you have Ansible resources. You can find Ansible resources for API Manager, Identity Server, Enterprise Integrator, and Stream Processor on GitHub. So if we take a look at the roles for something like API Manager, you can see that we have separate roles for each profile. So for example, we have a role for API Manager All-in-One, Traffic Manager, Store, Publisher, and so on. So let's take a look at our distributed setup. All right, so as you can see on the left, we have the terminal of our Ansible server, which has a light color. And on the right, we have the terminal of our Ansible node, which has a dark color. So keep in mind that you can have as many nodes as you want. In a typical distributed setup, you can have as many as 5, 10, even 20 different nodes. However, we will be only using one node for this demo, but the process will be the same no matter how many nodes you have. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is clone our Ansible project from GitHub. So since we're using API Manager, let's clone API Manager from GitHub. All right, so what we need to do next is very simple and straightforward. So if you want to try it out yourself, what you could do is you could go into the project repositories for any of our Ansible projects on GitHub and go through the documentation that we have provided. All right, so the first thing you need to do is you should download and copy a pack of your WSO2 product into the files packs directory. So I already have one with me, so let me do that. So first, let me go into Ansible folder. Files and packs. All right, so I have copied my WS2 API Manager pack into the packs directory. Next, what you should do is copy your JDK distribution into our Ansible server, into the files lib directory. So I will be using Amazon Curator as my JDK distribution. However, feel free to use whatever it is that you are comfortable with. So what you should do is go into your libs directory and copy your JDK distribution like so. All right. So one of the great things about Ansible is that you can define configurations for each of your environments. So if I go back to the root of the project, you can see that there's this folder called dev. So what does it do? Well, the dev folder has some sample configurations for a dev environment. So if you have more environments, what you could do is, as Vimukti said during a session, is that you could create similar directories such as, you know, staging, production, or whatever it is that you want, and it will create configurations for those deployments. So let's take a look into our dev environment. What you see here is that we have directories called groupvars, host bus, and a file called inventory. As Vimukti explained earlier, group bus contain variables and their values, which are common to sets of grouped hosts in our distributed deployment environment. And host bus contain variables specific to each host in our deployment. So if we take a look at our inventory file, we can see that within the square brackets, we have our groups. And underneath the square brackets, we have sets of hosts that belong to each group. So for each host, we should provide an IP address as well as the name of the user of that host. So let's provide the IP address of our Ansible node. So the first thing we should do is let's get its IP address. And then let's have it, put it here. And then let's put the name of our user here. For each host, we should provide an IP address of the host machine and its user. And for this demo, we will only be working with API Manager all-in-one profile. So let's we will not be working with the analytics profile. So let's comment them out for now. All right, so next, if we go back to the root of our project, we can see that we have the site.yaml file. So what does it do? If we go into it, we can see here is a set of configurations. Actually, let's go into the site.yaml file. And you can see a set of configurations explaining our hosts and the profiles that should be deployed in them. In here, we can see that the hosts we have defined in our inventory, APIM1, which is for API Manager all-in-one, as well as the profile that should run for that particular host, which is API Manager all-in-one. So if you want to learn more about the site.yaml file, we have given some examples below. If you want to run something like the API Manager store profile in one of your nodes, what you could do is give the name of that host in the inventory file, and then the role, which is APIM store, that should run on that node. Like that, you could even run multiple profiles or runtimes in a single host. So that is all you need to know in terms of, you know, setting up your Ansible server. So what you should do now is simply run the Ansible playbook command. So what are the arguments that we see here? The I you see here indicates the inventory file that we should run. So since you're running our dev environment, we should say dev. However, if you have multiple environments, you can provide the configurations for each of them in your Ansible project, as we talked about earlier, and simply run the Ansible playbook command, and it will make the necessary changes in the deployment that you specified. So let's do that. All right, so this should take a few seconds. While that is happening, let me explain what's going on. So what our Ansible playbook does is, first of all, it creates a user and a group within the host. And thereafter, it checks whether you have enabled performance tuning for the product that you are running. So if you have done that, it will make some system level configurations which will enhance your performance within the system. Thereafter, it will install the JDK distribution that you have provided. In my case, I have provided Amazon Pareto, and it will set it up on your machine. And then it will check if your pack has been updated. So I will get into updates in a little while. So as of right now, since we do not have any updates, what it will do is it will set up your product server and check if JDBC is enabled. So JDBC is used for database related tasks. And if JDBC is enabled, it will copy the JDBC driver. And then it will simply apply the Ansible commands. And finally, it will start the server. So that is what happens. And once it's done, you could go into your node and check if your API manager setup has been installed. As you can see, it says that our API manager server is active and running. So once it's done, you will have a fully functioning setup of API manager running on your node machine. Also, just keep in mind, as I said before, you can have as many nodes as you wish. So if your distributed deployment has as many as 20 different nodes, you could set up any WSO2 product as a distributed deployment using a single, let me say that again, single Ansible playbook command. All right, so that is it in terms of setting up and running WSO2 products using Ansible. Now let's get to why we're all here. Updates. How are we going to deliver updates to all nodes across a distributed setup? As Vimukti explained earlier, we will be using the in-place tool to update packs that we have copied into our Ansible server in the beginning. Actually, you don't even need to worry about this tool. Instead, what you could do is we have provided a script here. And the script that we have provided will update the product for you. So if you need to know more about the product, we have provided some documentation which you could go through. So let's get into our scripts directory and see what we could do with it. So if you need to know how we can use the scripts file, we could execute the script, we simply run update the script and the help command. And it will say that what you have to do is provide the script -p and give the name of the profile that you are updating. So let me do that. Since I am updating the API manager all-in-one profile, I'll say APIM and simply run the script. When you run the script, it will ask if you have a WSO2 subscription. You should say yes. Why is that? This is because you need a subscription to run updates on WSO2 products. So if you do not have a subscription, you could sign up for a free trial. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give my subscription credentials here. And it will start updating my API manager pack. So if you were able to attend our webinar, the first session of this webinar series on WSO2 updates, you would be familiar with the in-place updates tool. For those who couldn't attend the session, let me do a quick run through of what is going on here right now. So the first thing the in-place update tool does, it takes a backup of your current deployment, and then it starts downloading the updates downloading the latest updates for your deployment. As you can see here, it is downloading the updates, and once it's done, it will start applying those updates on top of your deployment. As you can see here, it has given the names of the files that it is updating, and once it's done, it will give you a message saying that the update has completed successfully, and it will repackage your deployment into a zip file. All right, so there you go. Your setup for WSO2 API Manager has now been updated. So how are we going to deliver this update to all of our deployments? I'm pretty sure most of you would have guessed it by now already. All you have to do is simply go into your Ansible project and run the playbook command. And once you run your playbook command, all of your updates will be applied to all of your agents and all of your nodes in the distributed deployment. So as I've said before, imagine you have a distributed setup of up to even 20 different nodes. All you will have to do is run the single Ansible playbook command that I just ran, and all of your 20 nodes will be updated. That is all you have to do. It's simple as that. All right, so our product has now been updated and applied all across our distributed deployment. So we have come to the end of our demonstration. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask us.
So we have a few questions so far. So let me go through one of them. So this question, actually this was asked before in a Puppet webinar as well. So do we have documentation on customizing these playbooks? Yes, we do have documentation on customizing these playbooks, as I mentioned in the webinar. So what you have to do is you have to go to your GitHub repositories for each WS2 product. And under the root, we have docs and we have the README. So in the README, you have the basic configurations. But if you go into the docs folder, you can find the documentation on customizing and as well as creating the recommended product profile, product pattern, product deployment patterns by WSO2. So there is another question. Hi. The Ansible script reboot the instances. Yes. Ansible scripts reboot the systems. So to apply any updates or configurations, we need to stop WSO2 servers. So we stop and restart WSO2 servers. But if you're asking about the instances as in the node, so we do not reboot the instance, but in case if you need to reboot your instances, you can write your own custom code and you can find the documentation with the WSO2 Ansible resources.
All right, so we have a question. What if a templated file received an update and there is a conflict between my change and the WSO2 update provider? So if there's a conflict between an updated file and your template, the update script is smart enough to identify that there will be a conflict. However, it will update the pack, but it will give you a warning saying that before you apply the Ansible playbook, you should make the necessary changes in your template.
Okay, there's another question. So can I use your Ansible resources in an auto-scaling environment? So say your environment is an AWS and you need to support auto-scaling there. So Ansible has modules on auto-scaling, so you can still use your Ansible resources, but you need to customize the Ansible resources, so you can follow our documentation and you can follow Ansible's documentation on auto-scaling your environment, and you can combine both of them to extend our Ansible resources. So there's another question. When running multiple roles in a single instance, do we have to manually configure port offset, or will it be done automatically from WSO2 provided Ansible resources? So actually we couldn't tell you. The WSO2 has parameterized WSO2 products. WSO2 Ansible resources has parameterized WSO2 products, but the values there, values we have given in the host was and group was contain the default values in the product. So there's no difference between Ansible role and Ansible API manager gateway role and Ansible and a WSO2 API manager product. So the variables there are the same. So you need to configure each and everything. So in a case of a port offset, yes, you have to configure it. So there's another interesting question. What is the difference between update SSH present in the Ansible repo script folder and the one comes with WSO2 WAM updated package? So actually, in the WSO2 WAM product, there is an executable, not a script. If you go to bin folder, there is update Linux executable, there is update Windows executable, and there is one for macOS as well. So this is the in-place update tool we talked about throughout this webinar. So we use that in-place update tool in an update SSH script, which is provided by Ansible, which is provided with the Ansible resources, and we use those features to update the product. So in case of a failure in production environment update, what is the workaround? So we do not recommend shipping the updates or the configurations directly to your production environment. Please keep your dev and staging environments identical to your production environment, and ship any configuration changes to the dev environment first, and then test it out, then ship it to the production environment. That's what we recommend. So please don't ship anything directly to your production environment. So there's another question. When we have executed update SSH on Ansible server, what it has updated the base zip file. So I think the question here is, so you have already configured and customized some WSO2 product and you call it the base zip file. I think that is the question. If not, please correct me. Please send another question. So assuming that it is the customized product, yes, it is the script that updates. It is the product that updated by the update SSH. But every time this update SSH runs, we create a backup. So it is in the backup folder. You can see it in the logs while running the update SSH script. So your base zip file will be backed up, so you don't have to worry about it. It will be backed up in the backup folder, so you can run the update. So if you want to roll back, you can just go and use the same base file. So that's looks like that's all we got. So let's give it 2-3 minutes, give it a 1 minute maybe, and then we'll wrap up. There's another question. What about existing custom configurations when updated through Ansible? Yeah, exactly. So as I said before, the in-place update tool is capable of upgrading your custom. Actually, that's not a problem. So your custom configurations will be applied through Ansible, right? So the product in the flowchart, if you could remember, the product is updated first, and then only your custom configurations will be applied to the product. So there won't be any conflicts with that. So what we do is we update the product using update SH, and then we apply whatever the configurations you have on top of that update on top to that product, and then we ship it to the node. So there won't be any conflicts. So in case a templated file is updated, the script will list it out. So you can go and manually change where this change has happened. Can revert functionality in place updates be used in here as well? So Samindu, you can answer that question.
Right. So the update script that we have provided does not have any functionality for revert. Basically, what it does is it updates your product and lets you know if you have any conflicts with files that are being updated and the templates that you have provided.
Actually, that's a good question. We'll think about adding it to our updated SH script. We'll add this as an issue, and we'll discuss it whether we can use it in our scripts, and then maybe we'll introduce it. Thank you. Okay, that's another question. Ansible resources for WSO2 products support Windows. Okay, so this is a no, but so we haven't got any requests from the customers to run our WSO2 products on Windows servers. So we haven't resources for to support on Windows. But if there's someone running your products on Windows, please send a request. We will provide Ansible resources for Windows. Okay, so that's about it. So we will move on because so at the beginning of the webinar, I talked about these resources. So here in the first link, we have WSO2 in-place update tool documentation. So please go through the in-place update tool documentation and go through the features and capabilities. And the rest of the links are WSO2 Ansible resources. So use them, go through them, and contribute to them. And if you have any questions, please feel free to email us or create a support ticket or create an issue, create a GitHub issue. That's about it. Please join us in our next webinar on continuous update delivery with AWS. Chin and Shafana will be here to present on that. And thank you very much for joining with us. Have a nice day. Bye.